We begin tonight with devastating news out of the United States. 19 children have been massacred in a shooting at an elementary school in Texas. Two teachers were also gunned down, dying, trying to protect their students. The gunman has been identified as 18-year-old Salvador Ramos, who killed his own grandmother before travelling onto the school and unleashing terror. The senseless tragedy sparking an emotional and powerful speech from the President Joe Biden, urging lawmakers to turn this pain into action. But Republican politicians have already ruled out any changes to America's lax gun laws.
A chilling video.
Oh,
capturing the teenage gunman in full body armour entering the school to carry out the second deadliest school shooting in American history. Salvador Ramos was shot dead by police, but not before he massacred at least 19 elementary school students, children aged 7 to 10 years old, and killing two teachers just a few days before the end of term. The weapons, two rifles he bought legally for his 18th birthday and then bragged about on social media.
My heart was broken today. We're a small community, and well, we need your prayers to get us through this.
Parents were sent to wait at reunification centres, going hours without news.
Her name is not here, you know, and we don't know a list of who's gotten flown out, and you're not letting us in at the hospital right now.
Others chose to wait at the scene. In some cases, parents were taken in to try to help identify bodies.
It was hard. They did take my sister to the back to identify, thinking it was my niece, but it wasn't my niece.
Desperate for answers, others posted on social media for news of their missing children. The family of Eva Mireles identified her as one of the teachers who was killed. The gunman also shot his grandmother before heading to the school in this car.
The suspect did act alone during this heinous crime.
What happened in Uvalde is a horrific tragedy.
But Republican politicians, like the Texas governor, ought to shoulder some of the blame for relaxing his state's gun laws, according to some parents.
Some of them will say our hearts are with the families. Well, guess what? The families don't need your freaking hearts. They need their kids. And the kids are not there anymore.
It didn't take long for the fingers to begin pointing towards Congress for failing to pass tougher gun laws. One Democratic governor saying, "Who the hell are we if we can't keep our children safe? This is preventable. Inaction is a choice."
Beg to literally get down on my hands and knees and beg my colleagues. Find a path forward here.
But even tonight, Republicans are unwilling to budge.
That doesn't work. It's not effective. It doesn't prevent crime.
So President Joe Biden pleaded with Americans instead.
I am sick and tired of it. We have to act. And don't tell me we can't have an impact on this carnage.
A sentiment echoing across America.
When are we going to do something? I'm tired. I'm so tired of getting up here and offering condolences.
But history tells us change is unlikely, no matter the price. Eamon Ashton Atkinson for 10 News First, Washington.